Dutch Sense here. 11:18 p.m. Central Time on Tuesday, October 7th, 2014. And we're looking at Earthquake 3D, which is a USGS feed of the most recent earthquakes. And I'm zooming in here on Mexico, Baja Peninsula, and you can see a 6.2 magnitude earthquake struck off the shores of Mexico, and that's in the Gulf of California. Let's go ahead and get the stats on this. We're looking at 6.2 miles deep, 10 kilometers, and they will probably adjust that depth and possibly the epicenter itself. Rather recent earthquake, and that could change when it comes to magnitude as well. However, when you look at the earthquake activity that's happened in the United States over the last several days, seeing the activity now in Mexico is no shock. So when we're looking at the last 48 to 72 hours of earthquakes here, here's the last 72, and we're looking at everything 2.5 and greater in the U.S., right down here where we see all the multiple 3.0 earthquakes. Also, in the past 72 hours, another 4.0 earthquake struck here in Oklahoma at the fracking operations, as well as a new swarm, small swarm, started here at the border of Colorado and New Mexico. So we're back to fracking earthquakes happening at the Colorado operation, which we don't see normally unless there's excessive activity to the west. So let's just go ahead and prove this to you, that this is a Colorado fracking operation. They don't normally talk about this much. They'll talk about the Oklahoma op, but they never talk about the Colorado operations causing these earthquakes. And when you see the size of it, you'll understand why they try to keep it hush-hush on the movement that's happening here. Okay, each one of these pads is a frack well, a frack operation. So what they'll do is they'll fracture out the shale deep down under the ground, and that will release natural gas, which they then collect. And they do that with wastewater. And I've marked these before, just some of them. I got tired of marking, there's so many of them. But you can see a 2.9 magnitude earthquake on September 30th. We had a 2.9 on February 9th. Down here we had 2.6, 3.0. So this has been a swarm spot for a long time. And when you see how big it is, again, it just goes on and on and on and on here for many miles. This is the area where the 5.0 magnitude earthquake happened in 2011. And that was on top of the 5.0 that happened in Oklahoma and the 5.0 that happened in Arkansas, all as a result of fracking. Now back to the earthquakes really quick. Let me just go ahead and show you the last 7 days of activity in the West Pacific. This is 4.0 and greater internationally, and it's just been a really phenomenal week in the West Pacific. We're talking about multiple volcanic eruptions happening in the West Pacific, as well as a series of larger earthquakes. The higher these are off the planet, the deeper they are into the Earth. So that just kind of lets you know that we're also seeing deep movement happening right below the plate in the asthenosphere, occurring all the way up to the surface almost, with a series of small, shallow earthquakes right along the surface, and I'm talking less than 1 mile deep up here just north of Australia. Nothing west of Greece in a while now, so that means we need to watch. We definitely need to watch near the Rock of Gibraltar, Strait of Gibraltar, somewhere in this region here in North Africa. Every time we see this earthquake activity spill to the west, it normally culminates here just east of the Azores. You can see the stack of earthquakes here at Bardarbunga Volcano still occurring daily. We're seeing 4 and 5.0 earthquakes kick off, and that's due to the volcanic eruption happening there at the new fissure or rift that split at Bardarbunga Volcano. Further south along the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, multiple 5.0s happening within, let's say, 200 miles of each other, right along the split of the ridge. And so that's, again, sign of the activity happening to the east and to the north. It does have a spillover effect. Again, you can just trace the earthquakes back across over to the main disturbance in the West Pacific. You can see, again, over the last 7 days, let me just take this back. You can see how the earthquakes pop off from west to east, going right up to Alaska. So we have two quiet points. One was Mexico, which was very quiet over the last several weeks, now having that 6.0 activity. That means the only other quiet spot that we should be watching now would be in between Alaska and British Columbia, Vancouver Island. Okay, so a lot of movement to watch. And if we just look at the 4.0 and greater activity over the last 7 days, you can see that even the United States is not immune to this movement. We're starting to see multiple larger earthquakes kick off, 4.3 and right at the border of Kansas and Oklahoma, 4.0 in Oklahoma, 3.9, 3.9, 3.9 right up the West Coast, and then now the 6.2 down here to the south. Always have an earthquake plan and ready, and be prepared just in case. You never know when you're going to have to use it. You may never have to. Let's hope you don't. But in earthquake-prone areas, definitely now is the time to be prepared. Not trying to bang that gong too hard. However, it is a good idea to dust those things off because of the amount of movement happening in the rest of the world. When you see this kind of activity happening to the west, you know something's coming to the east. The 6.2 is just a symptom of the greater problem. The greater problem, of course, is the West Pacific movement. Much love, guys.